This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
That's Alagiri's comeback to Amma's 45-minute monologue about the DMK's mother as strongman. But while the older brother is flustered by Amma's accusations, younger brother Stalin seems unaffected. Meanwhile, the Tamil Nadu government has defended its appointment of Letika Saran as the DGP yet again, submits a petition at the apex court. The upper house is embroiled in more legal trouble. A fifth petition has been filed challenging elections to the house. After 11th round of talks failed yesterday, NLC contract workers take to the streets of Cuddalore on the 31st day of the strike. 5 buses have been vandalized. Former MLA chooses the more direct way of stealing from the public, plays an income tax official and robs an 83-year-old man. Off-screen chemistry hits a low for Prabhu Deva and Nayanthara with fresh notices coming their way. A very good evening and welcome to the show with me, Ashmit Kumar. Now, those were some of the local developments in and around your city and the state. Let's also take a look at some national headlines making news. BJP drags the Prime Minister's office into the Commonwealth scandal, asks for a joint parliamentary committee probe. Meanwhile, the opposition charge comes to a day when the IT department raids a BJP leader along with 30 other locations in connection with the Games Overlay scam. Mumbai terror Kasab spits during video conferencing of office hearing. UK publication Guardian says Headley told Indian investigators he regularly reported back to the ISI. The Congress echoes the Sena line. Ashok Chavan tells NDTV Rohinthan Mistry's withdrawn book has objectionable language. Now it's the big story of the day. It's Amma versus Alagiri on battleground Madurai. After Jayalalitha's mega rally in what she dubbed as Alagiri land yesterday, the DMK Southern Region strongman has now hit back. From nasty remarks to back and forth accusations, this war of words has set the stage for the upcoming assembly polls. Sam Daniel reports.
DMK leader M.K. Alagiri hits back at Jayalalitha, whose show of strength on Monday in his bastion Madurai ruffled feathers. Madurai had been an AIADMK heartland for over 2 decades, politically nurtured by Amma's mentor MGR. The party lost control over the temple town as Alagiri turned to active politics in 2006. For the 2011 assembly elections, Jayalalitha has made Madurai a win-back mission, the rivalry scorching the political mood. During the rally, 2,000 policemen guarded Amma against an alleged death threat from the DMK. With assembly polls just 7 months away, the political temperature between the two Dravidian arch rivals is soaring and the battle is getting personal and murkier. In Chennai with camera persons Chandran and Edwin, Sam Daniel for NDTV.
Right, as the situation gets heated, election rhetoric has acquired a new colour post Jayalalitha's show of strength rally in Madurai. But even as reactions are pouring in from the DMK, the differences in the tone and tenor of reactions given by the two brothers, Stalin and Alagiri, has become the talking point within political circles. While DMK strongman Alagiri held little back and gave it back to the AIADMK full frontal, the younger brother Stalin chose to present an escapist front. Is this only the first indicator of the Madurai rally taking a toll? Let's first listen into the barrage of words Alagiri threw at Amma both in Madurai and here back in Chennai.
சார் வந்து திருப்பி ஆட்சிக்கு வரணும்னு சொல்றாங்க வந்த ஆட்சிக்கு வந்த பிறகு என்னென்ன மக்களுக்கு செய்யணும் சொல்லணும்
அதை விட்டுட்டு அவனை நாட்டை விட்டு துரத்துவேன் இவனை நாட்டை விட்டு துரத்துவேன்னு சொல்றது அதான் நாகரிகமா கேள்வி அதனால அந்த அம்மா
Right, so is that decent? Go and ask Amma. That's Alagri's response to Jayalalitha's open accusations at him yesterday. But if the older brother is busy getting flustered, the younger one stays calm, composed, and perhaps completely unaffected.
Jayalalitha had said something regarding needing actually a visa to go to Madurai.
We were joined by our senior correspondent Peer Mohammed, who described about the impact this is expected to have on the DMK brothers.
DMK will definitely sit back and think. The kind of crowd that AIADMK has seen in this particular rally, particularly after 17 death threats were received by the AIADMK backed JITV office, and this has we could see that whether it is Alagiri or Stalin, they are not able to answer properly the kind of allegations he has leveled against the DMK regime. And we have to wait for the DMK chief to react to Jayalalitha, because he last time Jayalalitha held rallies in Coimbatore and Trichy, Karunanidhi in fact gave answers in parts, like 5-6 statements in a row. No, he was not able to, because it's almost two hour speeches at Coimbatore and at Trichy also, because he touched on all the issues from PDS rice smuggling to the other issues like the Mullai Periyar dam issue, and these are big issues which need to be answered in a leisurely manner, which DMK chief and chief minister Karunanidhi did on earlier occasions. So we have to wait for the proper response from the DMK chief, but we know that either Alagiri or Stalin is not capable of handling these allegations leveled by ADMK Supremo Jayalalitha. That is visible in the response that we have got from them.
Right, now that rally in Madurai yesterday did not just take some brotherly feelings hostage. Even DMK's union minister Napoleon's car was attacked allegedly by AIADMK supporters. Let's take a look at the photo of the car that was released by Napoleon's office earlier today. Now, graduates turn professors of a different kind, and police have something to their credit while they get hold of them. We'll bring you more on that on the other side.